I have a question for you. Are you interested in using the quality measures designed by CMS to improve care in your facility? That is what we are going to discuss in this video. CMS derives the quality measures, or QMs, from the information that your facility provides in the MDS. That's right, the MDS is the sole source of information for your facility's quality measures. It is based on the specific outcome information of the residents in your facility. The QM information is used for three basic purposes. The first is the five-star quality rating system. This is used by consumers to select nursing homes. Here is an example of a five-star report that a consumer might see. And I want you to note the quality measure box in the center. The facility's overall rating is heavily influenced by the QM score. The second purpose of QMs is to help providers, such as you, improve the quality in your facility. The QMs identify those residents who are experiencing problems and compares your facility with other facilities across the country. And thirdly, the QMs come into play during the survey process. You should review your facility's QMs on a monthly basis to identify areas of potential quality concern. And here's how you begin. First, ask your MDS nurse to generate two reports for you, the facility quality measure report and the resident level quality measure report. The facility quality measure report should be reviewed first. This report displays the QM, the numerator and denominator used for each QM, the facility percentage, and how the facility compares with other facilities in the state and the nation. It's important to pay particular attention to the last column in this report, the comparison group national percentile. This column ranks your facility against all other facilities in the nation. Now, this ranking is different because we normally think of a high score as being a good thing, but in this case, it's bad. If you have a 99%, it does not mean you received an A. It probably means your facility has a potential quality problem. Any score higher than 75 warrants review by the facility's clinical team. On the report, you will see an asterisk next to any score above 75. That's to alert you that further analysis is needed. Now let's apply this to a hypothetical situation. If your facility quality measure report places your facility in the 90th percentile, in the last column for falls with major injury, you need to investigate why this number is so high. You have to start drilling down. You need to identify those residents who actually have that particular QM. That's where the second report comes into play. The resident level quality measure report identifies all residents, both active and discharged, who were included in the QM calculation. On this report, you will note the resident's name on the left, and the listing of the QMs will be on the right. For each resident who was identified with the QM, you will see an X. Make a list of all the residents with an X, and these are the people that you want to review for potential quality concerns. Now back to our hypothetical example, the QM fall with major injury. This identifies residents who've had at least one fall with an injury classified as major. This includes bone fracture, joint dislocation, closed head injury with altered consciousness, and/or a subdural hematoma. Based on this definition, your clinical team would then investigate your falls management process to identify any potential quality-related concerns and then correct those concerns. For example, are the falls assessments done appropriately? Are residents at high risk given proactive interventions? Have residents' medications been reviewed with a consultant pharmacist? Or has therapy been consulted regarding recommendations for fall prevention? You need to look at the whole picture and not just one individual aspect of care. Keep in mind, your QMs are designed to help you perform your job better and to improve the quality of care that we provide to our residents. Please use them. For additional information on QMs, please visit these websites.